In this video, I'm going to show you how to set up PostgreSQL chat memory to be able to have chat memory for your agents within n8n. Now, in order to do that, I have a very simple agent here. It's basically just a chat input with an agent that has access to memory. Now, if I take this for a second, I unhook the memory and I say something like, hello, my name is Bradford. It's going to say, hello, Bradford, how can I help you? Yep. And so if I say, what is my name? It's not going to know. It doesn't have any sort of memory at all. It's not persistent. It doesn't understand what I'm even asking because it's all it's getting is the chat input. Whereas if I hook this up here, now I already have memory set up. I'm going to walk you through the process in a moment. But I'm going to say, my name is Bradford, just like that. It's going to go, hello, Bradford, how can I help you? Yep. And then I'm going to say, what is my name? And it's going to remember it. And your name is Bradford. So perfect. So how do we get this to actually function? How can you set this up for yourself? So you need a Postgres node here. All right. I have found, and this is kind of a little tip or trick that I haven't seen too many other people talk about. There are ways to use Postgres as additional nodes. So I can have an actual just node that can insert rows, it can pull nodes, it can do all that. But if you have it try to insert a node, try to insert using just one of these nodes here, it's not going to work. And it's not going to work for the reason that it needs to have a table that it is inserting into. All right. And so in order to get it to create the table, because you don't need to create the table yourself, it will create the table. And in order to get it to create the table, we have to go through the process I'm about to show you using an AI setup just like this. Now, you could create your own table if you don't intend to have an AI chat memory like this. All right, there are other ways to use PostgreSQL to have memory tables and all that. So that's, I'm not necessarily saying you have to follow this process to use Postgres, but you have to use Postgres in this way, the way I'm about to show you, in order to get chat memory to work for your agentic systems in n8n. So I'm going to go ahead and close that, just get rid of that. What we're going to do is we're going to come into the Postgres chat memory node. We're going to go here, we're going to create a new credential. All right, now, this is all the information that I'm going to need in order to be able to set this up. I'm not sure where you're going to set up Postgres. I have mine come through Supabase. Supabase is really awesome. I put out another video the other day on how to set up Supabase. Go watch that video. I'll put a link in the description below for you for that one. To be able to set up Supabase, it's real simple, but I want to create Postgres and use Postgres here within it. How do I do that? Well, it's actually super, super simple, all right? Once you have your Supabase set up, you come over here to this button at the top that says connect. You don't need to worry about any of the stuff on the left. Come up to this button that says connect. You're gonna come down here to where it says session pooler, you know, view parameters, and all of this here is the information that you're gonna need in order to be able to set up Postgres within n8n. So I'm gonna grab our host, copy that, come back to n8n, paste that in. We need our database. Our database is just Postgres, so I don't think I need anything there. It's Postgres user. Our user is this one here. Grab that, paste that in. Our password, I will paste in just a second. If I need anything else, I need a 5432 is the port. 5432, number of connections is fine. SSL is fine. Let me go ahead and grab my password. Let's save it, see what happens. Here we go, save. It worked, no extra white space. All right, and there we go. We have a chat memory set up in our Supabase account now. And what we're gonna do is we're gonna come back here, we're gonna close that. And we'll have we're gonna name the table name here in this node. So whatever you want your chat memory table to be called in Supabase for n8n, this is where you're gonna set this up, all right? If you do not set it up here, you're not able to set it up elsewhere. I actually had somebody in my community the other day trying to set it up a totally different way. And like, we were scratching our head trying to figure out, how does this work? Well, it's because this is how you set up the chat memory. There might be another way of doing it. This is the fastest and easiest way I know how. And so we're just gonna call it n8n chat histories. And really quickly, let me come back to Supabase, come over to my tables, And you'll see that there is no table called n8n chat histories. It does not exist here. We'll come back to n8n. We're gonna go ahead and say, hello, my name. How about this? He already knows my name. No, it doesn't. Hello, my name is Bradford. It doesn't know my name because this is a different table, right? All right, and so now you saw it ran Postgres twice, once to check if there was anything in it for it to be able to reference, a second time to be able to put information into it. So we come back over here to Supabase. I'm gonna refresh our page. And now I have another table and I have two messages. One is human and the other is AI. And if I check, the human one says, hello, my name is Bradford. And the AI one says, hello, Bradford, how can I assist you today? So we were able to set up our table in Supabase using Postgres. And now our chat will be able to use it. Now I can create additional Postgres nodes here, just like this, that can insert rows in a table, select rows from a table, update rows in a table, whatever I want, because now the table will appear in here. Now I can have my chat history and pull however I need, update it however I need, in order to be able to have longer term persistent memory across my agents in my agentic system. So if you found this video helpful, please make sure to subscribe to the channel, like and share the video. It really does help get this information out there. And if you'd like additional helpful n8n tutorials or a bunch of free workflows, look at joining my free school community. The link is in the description below. I've got social media posting bots, lead scrapers, executive assistants, and so much more available all to you down in there. As always, I'm Bradford Carlton. Let's automate your success together.